OpenAI said it has completed a deal to raise $6.6 billion in new funding, giving the AI company a $157 billion valuation and bolstering its efforts to build the world's leading generative AI technology. In the last hour, the startups also announced a $4 billion credit line from banks around the world, giving it access to a more than $10 billion war chest. Bloomberg's Rachel Metz joins us on set in San Francisco, and we've been tracking this for weeks and months, and it's finally done. But the important point is they need the money because the cutting-edge model requires the money to train and build.
Yes, they are in a very expensive business. If you want to build a cutting-edge large language model, any kind of cutting-edge AI model at this point, you're looking at potentially spending up to hundreds of millions of dollars. So if you think about multiplying that out over a couple billion dollars, I mean, it's like, well, you can train a couple models there. What if, and what if you train one and you're like, you know what, I'm not that happy with this? I mean, it costs a lot of money. Also, they need, you know, chips, they have staff, they have all kinds of expenses there. They are bringing in revenue, of course, but it still costs quite a bit to do what they're doing.
It is the future revenue growth, the future profitability that means standout names from VC like Thrive Capital, like Kozla Ventures back the round, but numerous big substantial banks back the credit facility. We're looking at Goldman Sachs, JP Morgan, Santander, Wells Fargo, to name but a few. What is the future growth model that they're all building a $157 billion valuation on, Rachel?
I mean, they're looking at businesses using their products going forward. They're hoping that businesses will increasingly do things like fine-tune the models. They recently made it so that businesses can do that and use them in different parts of their workflow and find it useful enough that they will keep paying for it. And they are starting to see uptake. They have quite a number of both individual and business users at this point. They recently passed the 1 million business user mark for business users of ChatGPT in particular. But they still have a long ways to go if they want to get to this level that this valuation is showing them going to at some point.
There's two points I want to make really quick with my sort of finance coverage hat on. This is a pre-EBITDA private company or a pre-positive EBITDA private company. So that it could go to banks and get $4 billion in credit is remarkable. And also the eagle-eyed audience will say some of those banks are in Europe. That is also remarkable. Rachel, when they announced the closing of the equity round, they also gave us data on how they're doing, not necessarily financial metrics, but like how many people are using OpenAI. Do we know anything about like the scale of this company in the real world?
Yes, we do. We know that there are, I think it's 250 million weekly users of ChatGPT. As we previously reported, they also recently passed more than 1 million business users for ChatGPT. And that spans a couple different products related both to an educational product. They have a smaller business product, like for smaller companies, and then also like a larger, more enterprisey product. So they're definitely trying to hit at a lot of different people in a lot of different areas, and they are doing it. They are certainly bringing in revenue, and they are seeing users. I think what remains to be seen is how well this will all work over time. What kind of, you know, investors have to be willing to wait. They have to be very patient, right? This is not like your average startup where it's like, well, you know, you might get a short-term return and then maybe you'll get a long-term return. This is like, well, you're going to have to wait and see what we come up with over time.